And I'm just, it's no particular order. We're just going to call them up. We're going to tell you some good things about them, and we're going to present them with these awards that we've been so gracious to be allowed to get. And since the first award right here is number 27, Jimmy Edwards, if you come up. Stand there and face that crowd. I don't know. That's against my first year. I just heard Coach say 4 years. I know Coach has been here longer than anyone on our staff, right? I probably should give the mic to Coach to talk about Jimmy. I can just tell you the impression he's made on me. He's already got an offer from St. Andrews, and if he chooses to go there, that's good for him. If he doesn't, and chooses to go somewhere else, that's good for him also. But all I know is Coach Harper, the head coach there, asked me, he said, Coach, that's all I want to know. Would he have been one of your first signees at Southeastern? I said, without a doubt. Without a doubt. And I'm going to tell you why. Jimmy, and I didn't know how to take Jimmy when I first got here. I didn't know if he was. I didn't know. I couldn't figure him out. I didn't think he was all in or with us, I should say. So I kind of watched from afar, watched what he did, and then as the year kind of unfolded, and I was telling another player this about him the other day, but as the year unfolded, he became a player we couldn't do without. I remember yelling at him during a game, Jimmy, we need this stuff, we need this. Jimmy, you need to give a little more there. And never one time did he look back and say, Coach, I'm giving you all I got. All he did is say, yes, sir. And then we'd get on the field and Coach Martin would say, Coach, because he knows what I mean. Coach Martin's always he's your bodyguard. You know that. He's wanting to fight me on the sideline, and I get it. But he'd say, Coach, Jimmy probably had one of the better games, didn't he? And I said, yes, sir. And it was always. I mean, he didn't miss a read. Whatever Coach asked him to do, he did. Whatever we asked him to do. And, you know, usually every place I've been except one, Coach Martin and them school, at the end of the year, seniors leave. Last day, seniors got to get out of the way. Because it's their time, and they deserve it. And I need to remember a little more how I behaved at that age, and maybe I'd understand some of these things that's going on. But Jimmy, he's in the weight room every day. He's encouraging our kids every day. He's helping every day, just as if he was as much part of the team next year as he was the 4 years that Coach Bullitt talked about, and that's character. I hope he does great in college. I told Coach Harper, I said, Coach, this is a kid you don't have to worry about coming the first year, leaving, coming home. Because when he comes and he gets to school, he's going to be committed to an education. He's going to be committed to doing the right things. And I promise you're going to fall in love with him. And Jimmy, if I talk too much somewhere along the way, I probably will cry. But I don't want to start crying on the first one. So, man, I want to tell you I love you and I appreciate you more than you'll ever know. Jimmy Edwards. Next one, Mark Johnson. Come on up. If you was figuring it, I wish you would. Like my coach was talking about Superdome. I mean, Mark missed it. You and Coach talk about us butt heads. Mark is extremely talented, extremely talented. And I think there's so much more in Mark that I so bad that I want to see him bring out. And I think his best days are ahead of him. Not that the best days are not ahead of all our kids, but I just think there's so much more in him. And hopefully I encourage you every day now that it's done to bring that out in you, because you got some special qualities about you, not just as an athlete, just in what the good Lord bless you with. And I'm going to say this, and I try not to share too much here, but I'm guilty. I can't keep my mouth shut about too many things. But Mark had a hiccup during the middle of the season, and it was a little more than a hiccup. And it was what it was, and we kind of went on our way, and I remember talking to Coach Benton about it. And usually, it's not my first time, but usually when a player makes a mistake and you make a decision on a player, that needs to be it. I don't believe you go back on them. I just don't think it's good for the team. I don't think it's good for anyone involved, and especially if you're in the first year of your program. And as me and Mark was working through that, he came in. At first, his parents wanted to meet, and man, they came in. I was just taken back by the way they approached the whole thing. I mean, it just was the highest character. Usually, when you got a parent at your door, you tied in your belt. You know what I mean? And that's not the right attitude to have. I'm not saying that, but they walk in, and I'm telling you, they just got me humbled in my seat. And then I began to pray about it and pray about it. And Mark would come after practice and pray about it and pray about it. And I didn't know whether I was making the right decision or not. You know, sometimes you just got to make one. I tell you what, I told him that Scriven game. I told him, I said, if I had to do over again, I'm so happy that he came back. Bless my heart, Major. Thank you, Mom. That ain't good. That ain't good, Mom. Moved you down there, bro. Lane Adams, come on. It ain't a one-year wonder, because he's got an awesome career ahead of him too. You know, not I'm terrible with names. I didn't even have Lane's name memorized well. His mom meets me at church just to let me know he would not be a football player. And so that was a challenge. No, I wasn't. It was, and the good Lord just, it was awesome how it worked out. Coach Hayes had told you a bunch of his story. So I'm not going to repeat that again. I'm just going to tell you that you saw the verse up there, good names will be more desired than great riches, favor is better than silver or gold. You know, so many times, whether it's a teacher out on the bus ramp, Mr. Griffin was out there the other day telling me about one of the kids in school, just talking about a good name. Wasn't even a football player, just his kid. As a kid, we got in the gym. We never know. You know, every day, Coach Hodges used to tell me, every day you're on interview, Coach. Everything you do, you're interviewing. Lane was in my weightlifting class when I first got here, when everybody was kind of getting accumulated to us and running. Coach Farrell would meet him at one end of the hall, and I'd catch him on the other end of the hall, and we'd bounce him back and forth. Lane was a stud from the word go. Never said a word, never got caught up in a drama. Come to class every day, work hard, begging to play football. I don't know, gave me all that. Next thing you know, you see him out there practice again, Coach. Hey, he's told you a story. We get out there at Tell Fair, and Lane's a punter. Well, we had to miss a couple games because we missed spring practice, so Lane's a punter. We go to Tell Fair, we're playing one of the best passing offenses. I mean, as for a single 18, they got it going on offensively. Had a couple of receivers that went big time, just signed. They got one coming back. And we got a situation at corner. I walk up to Lane Adams. I said, hey, Lane, he's the punter. And he plays receiver, but he's the punter receiver. Now you think about this, all y'all that play football. I said, Lane, you're starting at corner Friday night. He said, yes, sir. Goes out. Plays a well of a ball game. I mean, we learned some things in that ball game, and he learned some things. But how many guys would do that? How many of us have the confidence and we have the work ethic, so we've got the character, we believe enough in ourselves to go out and do what he did for us this season, then average almost 40 yards a kick. And I know he loves baseball, and I hope he plays Major League Baseball. Whatever his dream is, I hope he accomplishes it, because that's what he gives back to us. You don't know what a joy it is to coach you, a joy it is to see you every day, fifth period, and just a joy it is to be able to talk about what awesome character you have. So, man, God bless you, and I wish you the best. Lane Adams.